Thanks for joining us. March Madness and the Women's Final Four is now underway. Basketball fans have flocked to downtown. In fact, Meet Minneapolis expects the games and all the other festivities will draw up to 30,000 people this weekend. We have team coverage tonight. Andy Mack will preview the UConn game and hometown hero Paige Beckers. And Chris Hrabsky spent some time downtown today checking in with fans and businesses. Happy to see the crowds. We're going to check in with Chris first. Chris?
Hey, Randy. Yeah, there is a palpable feeling of optimism in downtown Minneapolis right now. You got people flying in from around the country to attend the Final Four. You got business owners who are filling their seats right now. It's something they haven't seen in 2 years, and it's something a lot of people are welcoming back. For 2 years, pain paused the heart of Minneapolis.
If you're not dispersed, you will be arrested.
Deadly violence.
It simply is unacceptable.
Peaceful protests.
Hands up! Don't shoot! Hands up! Don't
shoot! Pursuits of justice.
Find the defendant guilty.
Empty streets, empty buildings, widespread fear in a pandemic.
And where are you guys from?
We're from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina.
Today, a familiar feeling returns.
Well, I'm excited about seeing our girls play.
Basketball fans from across the nation flying in, staying in, and partying in downtown Minneapolis.
Yeah, it's going to be a big night, I believe. Big weekend.
They're doing a really, really good job hosting this tournament. Yeah. It's been a lot of fun so far.
Well, I think we're starting to make a turn for the better.
For Tim Mahoney, owner of the Loon Cafe, a sorely needed spark for business.
You've got people coming and going. We got the Women's Final Four. I mean, these are the things that we need to get us back on the map as a great city, not only to come for events, but also to come and visit at any time.
Yeah, we were closed for 13 months.
A block away at Glick's, the big weekend brings cautious optimism.
It's great. When there's not events, there's not that many people downtown still, but we're looking forward to this weekend for sure.
I didn't know anything about Minneapolis before I came. Happy to be here. Lots of good food, I think, breweries, so ready to check them all out.
Right on.
All right, so you got the Final Four this weekend. You got the Twins home opener next weekend. You got the Wolves vying for a playoff spot. These are vital events for businesses around here. One thing some business owners told me, though, that hasn't come back yet to what it was is the nightlife. And they hope that is something that comes next. All right, enough of that. And now we turn to why we're here, which is the games. For more on the Final Four and the hometown hero returning to the Twin Cities, we go over to Andy Mack. What's up, bud?
Hey, thank you, Chris. Well, fans are still filing in here to the Target Center, and I will apologize to Stanford in advance because I don't think Paige Beckers needs any motivation, but the last time she played in this facility, she lost. That was when she was a member of Hopkins back in 2018 in the girls basketball state title game in a loss to Eastview, UConn, and Beckers takes on Stanford in a little bit. The late cap tonight, the former Hopkins star has been in the spotlight for so long that, well, this moment really doesn't feel too big for her just yet. On the other side, the Cardinals say they know what they're up against, but, well, this will be the first time taking on Paige in person.
She is not a one-dimensional or what I say is a one-trick pony. She has a lot of different great skill set. She's a tremendous passer, scorer. I think she can do it all.
To compete against Paige and UConn, because we know that they have a very strong offensive team. And like Tara said, Paige has a lot of things up her sleeve. So try to not let her do what she wants to do.
The reigning national champion, Stanford, they are the reigning champs. So they'll take on UConn in the nightcap. Louisville taking on South Carolina right now. And the winner of both those games will face for the national title trophy, a big one outside Target Center. So it's a big game, two big games tonight from the Final Four. We'll, of course, have more coverage coming up tonight at 10. Back to you guys.
All right. Thanks, Andy.